Audio Guide Vienna. We would like to wish you a warm welcome to Vienna and to thank you for choosing our audio guide. In purchasing our product, you will have not only acquired a detailed audio guide that will guide you through all of Vienna's most beautiful spots, but also have a lasting reminder of your stay. Start. Maria Theresa Square. U2, Museums Quartier. Take the underground railway, line number 2, to the station Museums Quartier and walk from there to Maria Theresa Platz. We are now standing at the feet of the mother-in-law of all Europe, as Maria Theresa, the Empress of Austria and Queen of Bohemia and Hungary, was called. Maria Theresa brought a total of 16 children to the world. She managed to marry most of her children off into dynasties throughout Europe. Her most famous daughter was Marie Antoinette, the wife of Louis XVI, who was decapitated during the French Revolution. The Maria Theresian era was characterized by wide-reaching reforms that brought about significant modernization throughout the lands of the Habsburg Empire. Maria Theresa introduced compulsory schooling for all, improved farmers' living conditions, abolished slavery, and made the first steps towards modernizing the administration. Her husband was Franz Stefan I. The monument, however, does not show Maria Theresa sitting amongst her large family, but instead surrounded by her advisors and some composers, including Willibald Gluck, Joseph Haydn, and Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart as a child. Maria Theresa lived in the 18th century from 1717 until 1780 and reigned from 1740 until her death. Museum of Art History, Museum of Natural History. Two buildings, alike to the point of being identical, demarcate Maria Theresa Square, the Museum of Natural History and the Museum of Art History. Distinguishing one of the museums from the other is not the easiest task for the visitor. The trick is as follows. Take a closer look at the figures that grace the tops of the domes on each building and try to make out the difference. A nude statue crowns the Museum of Natural History, whilst the figure on the roof of the Museum of Art History remains clothed. Both buildings were constructed in neo-Renaissance style between 1871 and 1891. Despite the state having just survived bankruptcy, the two architects, Gottfried Semper and Karl von Hasenauer, did not have to skimp costs during building. Emperor Franz Joseph, who approved the erection for the two buildings, emphasized the importance of a worthy home for the works of art collected by the Habsburgs over the centuries. Originally built as a private museum for the family, today the museums are thankfully open to any visitors. The main emphasis of the painting collections at the Museum of Art History is on the 15th to 18th century masters. Its collection of works by Peter Bruegel the Elder is of particular interest. The Museum of Art History houses around a third of all the pictures produced by this Dutch painter. The Museum of Natural History evolved from Kaiser Franz I's collection of specimens from the world of nature. Here, a vast array of stuffed, preserved, and dissected animals of all genera and species are exhibited in innumerable glass cases alongside fossils, minerals, and semi-precious stones. In the prehistoric section, you will find, for example, the world-famous and 25,000-year-old carved stone figure, the Willendorf Venus. To have enough time to visit both museums, you should allow at least 2 to 4 hours for each building. We are now leaving Maria Theresia Platz, or Square, and walking straight ahead in the direction of the Hofburg, the Imperial Palace. This means that now we must cross the so-called Ring Road. The Ring is a multi-lane, one-way street that encircles Vienna's first district, the historic city center. The road runs alongside where the old city walls of Vienna used to be. These served as defense and fortification for the city, even through the Turkish siege of 1683. From the start of the 19th century, the glacis, as the walls were then called, were used as a beloved promenade by Viennese men and women. Finally, in 1857, Kaiser Franz Joseph ordered the demolition of the city stronghold walls and the construction of the ring road. The ring road is noticeably wide. This was a matter of military consideration. In the construction plan's so-called motivation report, Franz Joseph stated that particular consideration is to be given to military strategy. The Kaiser feared an attack by enemy troops much less than the threat of a revolution by residents from the outskirts of the city. For this reason, the ring road was built particularly wide, so as to allow troops and materials to be transported as quickly as possible, and, at the same time, to make building barricades difficult for revolting citizens. The plots of land on which the city walls stood were either sold or rented. With this revenue, Franz Joseph financed a number of expensive administration buildings. Outer Palace Gates. Now we are arriving at the Hofburg Palace through the Outer Palace Gates. They were originally erected to commemorate the Battle of Leipzig of 1813, in which Napoleon was defeated. In the years 1933 and 34, they became a memorial for those killed in action in the First World War, and since 1945, they have also served as a memorial of honor to the victims of fascism. On the gates, you will find two Latin inscriptions in golden letters, which can be translated as follows. Franz Joseph, Emperor of Austria, 1824. And beneath this, Laurels for the Laurel-Worthy Soldiers, 1916. On the inner side of the gates, the following inscription was added. Justitia Regnorum Fundamentum. Fairness is the fundament of rulers. Hofburg, start. We are walking through the palace gates and are now in the Imperial Palace, in German, Hofburg. The heart of the Hofburg is a medieval fortified castle annex, the construction of which began in the second half of the 13th century. Over the course of the centuries, the Hofburg gradually changed its appearance from a fortress into a huge palace complex, and served until 1918 as the imperial residence. Right up until the Habsburg dynasty collapsed, each ruler had a wing torn down and a new one built in its place.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.